Let's run MRP. Now in this screen, I'll tell you few things. This is a screen of MRP run. I am running for single item multiple level. Means I can run MRP for one material, but that MRP will be available go up to the multiple levels. Okay. So this is my material plant. Now this is a very important key, processing key. What is this processing key? Here we'll have a three processing key. The first is NETCH. NETCH is a net requirement planning. Okay, suppose, do you know the planning file entry concept?
No.
So whenever we run the MRP, system generates or store the records of MRP run in one file, or we can say in one table, which we call the planning file. Okay, so for this processing key, just tell us that by the using this processing key, we can tell system that whether system should consider the planning file entries changes or not. If we talk about the first part, NETCH, net requirement change, net change in total horizon, it means that our horizon is of 100 days. And in 100 days, definitely we are going to run MRP multiple times. Okay, so system will plan only which material which has undergone in some planning. Okay, and as I run, suppose I am running MRP first time. So whenever I run the MRP first time, system will pass that material and details in your planning file entry. Mean that now planning file has a record that you run the MRP. Okay, after that, if I select this first one, then system will plan only for those material which has undergone some kind of planning. Okay, it mean that system will recheck your planning file. Then next is come NETPL. In NETPL system, again it will check your planning file entry and system will run MRP that undergone into change relevant to your planning run. In first case, system will check system will check planning file entry for a single planning level. System will check whether it is done or not. In second case, system check if it is done, what was my earlier situation. Okay, and in third case, this is called the regenerative planning. In regenerative planning, system want to go to check your planning file entry. System will simply plan whatever material is assigned with the MRP type in your material master. This MRP type regenerative planning is useful where you have a very short lead time. And these two above are useful where you are doing your production horizon or your planning horizon is very long. Okay. Then comes the second key. It is about the creation, how system will create the purchase requisition. So here, the first is purchase requisition. It is simple, system will create the purchase requisition. Second, purchase requisition is opening period. What is opening period? We have one planning horizon, and our planning horizon is of 100 days. So the first day will be called as opening period. Okay. Then comes the planned order. This planned order is not relevant here because system is already will calculate the planned date at the time of by referring your production order. Then comes scheduling line. How system should. Now come the scheduling line. The concept of scheduling line is again similar, which we have seen in case of a purchase requisition. No scheduling line means that the system shouldn't do any kind of scheduling. Okay, it will give us a one default date. What happened? Suppose you have one purchase requisition, but your final delivery will be decided by your buyer with reference to negotiation between buyer and vendor. Okay, if you want that system should fix one schedule, one scheduling date, no scheduling should be taken, then we'll select this one. Then second, scheduling lines in the opening period. In that case, system will consider the planning horizon start date as my opening period. And third is scheduling line. In that case, system will schedule your purchase acquisition as per the your production plan. It will give you the different scheduling.
Production or the lead time?
First of all, it will check. See, first of all, system what know? System know your production order date. Okay. So, system is plan according to your production order date. For calculation of your delivery time, it will go to Metal Master or scheduling agreement or somewhere. Now comes MRP list. It is again a kind of report that whether system should generate. Yesterday we have seen the one T code which is called the stock requirement list. If you remember, stock whenever MD04. So whenever you run the MD04, system will give you the new situation, means current situation. But what is MRP run? What is MRP list? MRP list is the outcome of MRP. Suppose you run MRP right now, okay, and after that, after 5 to 6 hours or before last MRP run, you want to know the what was my situation after MRP run. So that situation will be available in MRP list. But if you want to know current situation after 2 days, then that current situation will be available in your stock requirement list. Okay, then comes the planning mode. This planning mode is relevant to your planning process. Here we define that in a normal planning mode. In a normal planning mode, system will explode your BOM and routing one by one. Okay, in case of a second planning mode, system will keep exploding your BOM and routing until he gets the desired shortage quantity. In case of a third, delayed and regrade planning, here system will understand that he doesn't have any BOM and routing. Okay, so that system will consider the planning run as a fresh planning run, the first planning run. Okay, now we see here the process control parameter. If you want that also plan unchanged component, okay, this is applicable. If I click here, then system will change the different component which are component relevant to your bill of material. Okay, then the display result before they are saved. If you want to know the results of MRP run,
okay,
before saving, then this is helpful. Suppose you have a 5000 plan and you want to know okay what is my purchase acquisition quantity, and after knowing the purchase acquisition quantity, if you want to reduce your plan because you don't have that much money in your company or whatever the reason. Okay, so this help us to know the situation prior to saving.
That should be checked.
That must be checked. Okay, then display material list is simply list down our material. Okay, then simulation mode. Simulation mode is again a same kind of thing. In Miro, what we do, we post the entry, then we simulate. In simulation system, what shows what he is going to post.
We first simulate, then post.
This is again a simulation mode. So if I select the simulation mode, then system will show me the situation. Okay, and after that it will boost.
Okay.
Okay, so now I'll press the enter. As I press the enter, system will plan. This is a my situation. What is my situation now? My plan is 5,000, right?
Yes.
Yesterday we have taken GRN of one production order of 200 metric ton.
Yes.
So it means that here is shortage of 4,800. Now against that 4,800, I have one production order already, because we created two production order initially. One was for 200, another was for 100. So for first production order 200, we already taken the receipt. So the receipt is coming here, 200. We also created one production order of 100 number. So system considered the production order in receipt quantity. Okay.
Receipt quantity. That means
this is called receipt of or required quantity. I mean all the calculation, whether it is negative, positive, will come here, and outcome of calculation will come here.
And in the production order 794, we have booked the quantity for 100 material. Okay, and the available quantity is system showing the 4,700.
This is not available, Ajay. This is in negative. It means that this is your difference. This is your shortage.
Shortage of finished goods.
Shortage of slated coil, finished goods.
See. Just see the difference. Here 4,800. We have already having 200. We require a product of 5,000. Now the negative is 4,800.
Right.
And here we again book that the 100.
It is not booking. It is showing that you have one production order. See, this is you have one production order of 100 metric ton.
Okay. 100 metric production order. And here saying that the 4,600 is a net or negative.
Negative. It means that you need this much, you required to produce this much quantity.
4,700.
Yes.
But earlier, you are requiring the 4,800.
They are not getting your voice clearly. What are you saying?
Earlier in the 4,800 negative.
See, system just calculate in this way. Okay. First 200 is my stock, then system go and check what is your requirement. So now system find out 4,800 is your shortage quantity. Then system again find one production order. So system go and check what is the difference between 4,800 and 100, which is your received or required quantity. Now system come to know 4,700 is your shortage quantity. Okay, so it is, there is no record beyond 4,700. Okay, so after that system generated one planned order. This is your generation planned order.
And what is that? The 5,000? What was the 5,000? Immediate requirement. Immediate requirement on what basis? This immediate requirement. I want to know. Further, we're missing this point.
This is your initial plan. Just I show you. You remember in MD-61 we entered one plan.
5,000. Yes, I remember that. I recall my memory. Yes. It was a requirement, right? This was the plan order. Okay, that was the production order.
This is our requirement. 5,000 is our requirement.
Requirement. This was the plan.
This is our production plan.
This is production plan. Right.
So this is my production plan. I have 200 already in stock. It means that I need 4,800 more. But against that 4,800, I have 100 metric ton production order. It means that my shortage is 4,700.
Right.
So system generated one planned order of 4,700.
Order means we have an order in hand. We need to produce, but the raw material for the 100 required, this is not considered for the further requirement. Raw material for creating the production order.
No, it will consider. This is your raw material. It will also consider raw material. It exploded na bomb, because this is for this slitted coil. This is your finished product, right? For this, 2860 is your raw material.
2860
is your raw material code number. So, what if you remember initially, what was the name of your initial screen? Single item multi level.
Single item multi level.
See, this is your raw material situation.
This is a raw material situation.
Okay, this is raw material situation. You have a order of, we have 1:1 ratio. For 5,000 finished product, we need 5,000 raw material. Okay, so you have
0-1 in stock.
Stock. Then system also consider your reservation. What is this reservation? This is a reservation against your production order. We have 100 metric ton order, so it means that for against that order, system also reserved 100 metric ton. Okay, so it nullified here. See, so what system is saying, you have a 100 metric ton production order, it means that this 101 is not of your use, because you have an already production order. Okay. And now comes your dependent requirement. What is this dependent requirement? Earlier we have seen that for our final MRP run, finish quantity is 4,700. It means that you need to produce 4,700 more. So for shortage quantity, system is planning your material. So now system will consider 4,500 quantity for planning, because for the same quantity you need to produce also.
This is the purchase order. Purchasing point, line number 4. But PCH order. It's the purchase order.
This is a purchase order currently you have in your system.
My system.
Okay.
55. Okay. And these are the purchase order. Now the required quantity 3,600. This is again the order. This is again the order. Required quantity.
See, 4,700 is your planned quantity, right? Okay. Against that, here is a one word short. It means that earlier your stock was, you had a stock of 101. You have a reservation of 100. It means that you can use 1 metric ton, right? Then you have a plan of 4,700. So against that 4,700, system subtracted the available stock. Now your requirement is of 4,699. Against that 4,699, you have one purchase order of one number. So system again reduced your required quantity by one. So now 4,698 is your new required quantity. Now you have one more purchase order for 1,000 numbers. It means that system will again reduce your quantity by 1,000 numbers. So it is saying that you have a shortage of raw material by this much. By this quantity.
Okay,
this is your shortage. So what system has done for your shortage, system has given us purchase acquisition, procurement proposal. Why it has given the procurement proposal? Because this is my raw material. We are not going to produce raw material in house.
That means for the date of delivery 11th, raw material, the 3698 is the requirement.
Yes.
there's some problem in the sound. You may be experiencing network congestion difficulty. Okay. Okay. No one understood that happening. Thank you.
So I'm just now I'm simply saving this. Okay.
Will you generate that? This is my field. No? Really, it will show the entire. It has already changed the entire status.
It is already showing this. That's why you should always use this functionality of simulation mode. Yeah, this in this server first time is MRP run. What is the outcome of MRP run? It will also say what is the outcome of MRP run. How much material he has planned? He planned for two material. First is our finished product. Second is your bomb component.
Okay,
and what are the parameter he has used? What was our input parameter? See, it is our plant, MRP area, processing, Cree. This was our input parameter. Now it is saying that what he has generated. He has generated one plan order for your production, finished product. He has generated one purchase acquisition for your raw material. And it has also generated one dependent requirement, which was of 4,700.
Then the two purchase order generated 1,000 and 1,000.
That was not purchase order was not generated. We had a purchase order already in system.
Already having the purchase order in system. System generated the purchase requisition. 7260. Last. Error?
What?
No, this is a message.
This is just confirmation message. This is just confirmation message that what system has done. I'll do one thing. I'll show you an MD04 stock requirement list.
It doesn't look like a web error window.
See, this is a stock requirement list. This is a stock requirement list for my finished product. This stock requirement is same list which we have got after the simulation of your MRP run. Okay, now we'll see the stock requirement list of our raw material. This is stock 101 we have in system. Now against that 101 stock 100 production order is available, then system consider that you'll use the 100 stock against your production order. Now the system said you have still one quantity available to use. Then this dependent requirement comes on basis of your finished product planning requirement. Okay. Against that you have one purchase order in system of one number. That it means that he subtracted the reduced the quantity by one number. After that you also has one purchase order of 1,000 numbers, so it again reduced the quantity by 1,000, and this after that it has given us a purchase acquisition. Now suppose what I'll do one thing, I'll just update something here. We'll rerun the MRP and we'll reduce this quantity. Okay, let us do one time. This is our requirement. Suppose I'll create one purchase order of 98 quantity. Okay, now again refresh my list. See, system has considered this quantity. Okay, system is saying that you have one purchase order of 98, but system hasn't changed my purchase acquisition because The purchase requisition changes are subjected to MRP run. If I again run the MRP, then system will change it.
Okay.
We'll again run the MRP. See, it has given a message, purchase requisition changed one number.
One number.
Let's see what is changed. See, it has reduced by 98 numbers.
One requisition, that means early requisition 7260, is it marked deleted or is it cancelled?
No, no, it is just similarly, it is changing the same purchase requisition.
Okay, but 7260, same requisition.
Same requisition, it has changed. Because we hasn't done any, because this equation is still open, we not converted into purchase order. Okay, till the conversion in purchase order, system can change it dynamically.
In the existing PR.
Come again?
It will change in the existing PR.
Existing PR.
The existing earlier PR, which was created, the 369. System has changed that the quantity is in the same PR.
Same PR. I'll do one thing now, I'll again. That's why system is giving us message that plant requisition changed one. If we would have created any, if we could have created any new requisition, in that case, system will give us a message, plant requisition created as one.
Changed. MD02 is the MRP run.
Yes. Single item, multiple level. Generally this, I mean, for the, you can run by MD01 also, but MD01 is not relevant to your material. It will run for your total plant. MD01 is generally preferably used for your manual reorder point planning or automatic reorder point planning. Okay. So yeah, Ajay, since 3 to 4 days we covered lot, huh? I think we have make up the delay which were before 2 weeks or
I will do the fair.